All right, and we are live. Good evening po sa inyo lahat mga kaguro. And of course, welcome back to Gurong Pinoy. And of course, binabati natin yung ating mga let babies for September this year. The members of Team Dewey, ang mga minamahal nating pinakabagong let babies, of course, they will be taking the let in September this year. We already have two sections for our Team Dewey. Meron na po tayong Team Dewey A and of course, meron na ding Team Dewey B. And of course, tonight, we are going to have the second part of our refresher discussion, okay? So again, we welcome all the members Team Dewey, no? Diyan din yung mga Team Pavlov members natin, yung mga Team Waiting, and of course, malapit na ng maging licensed professional teachers. And of course, dito po sa Gurong Pinoy, hindi namin kayo iiwanan sa ere, no? Wala pong iwanan hanggang sa day that you take the let. Andyan pa rin po yung Gurong Pinoy nag-guide sa inyo, natutulong sa inyo na makikibaka kasama ninyo para of course, no, sigurado maipapasa yung ating licensure exam for teachers. Meron din po tayong SPLE, no, sa mga magti-take po ng let sa June naman po, dyan sa Singapore and of course sa Middle East. You can also join our SPLE group, no, dire-diretso din ang ating pagre-review sa June naman po yung kanilang licensure exam for teachers. Again, that is going to be in Singapore and also in the Middle East. Now, we also have our civil service for August, of course, a review program. This is also 100% online and we will be starting by this month too. On the 27th, we are going to have our orientation, of course, diagnostic test. On the 28th, and dire-diretso din po, just like our let, no, until the day that they take their exam, andito yung Gurong Pinoy coaches to guide all of you para maipasa din po yung inyong civil service exams. Okay? And of course, pinakabago nating programa, no, we have heeded, no, your call, your requests of opening our NAPLCOM online review. And so, no, nandito rin po tayo to help all those people, lahat ng mga kapulisan natin, no, mga nangangarap maging bahagi ng Philippine National Police. We also have the NAPLCOM online review. So again, no, if you'd want to join any of our programs para wala pong balakid, wala pong pagpuputol, no, sa inyo pong panonood, dire-diretso yung panonood. And of course, you can join our quiz, you can download all our files, become a member of Gurong Pinoy CSE, LET, SPLE, andyan din po, and of course, NAPLCOM review programs. Just send a message to this Facebook page at andyan po yung mga admin natin na tutulong sa inyo, mag-guide sa inyo, of course, sasagot po sa lahat ng inyong mga katanungan on how to become a member of Gurong Pinoy. Okay, now, as I've mentioned, this is refresher for Gen Ed Science, and of course, this is made especially for all our Team Dewey babies, and of course, no, kindly like, love, and share na po ng ating video so that we can reach out to more people. And of course, para dire-diretso po yung ating panonood. Kung medyo blurry po yung inyong video, just find the settings icon at i-change po yung video quality into a higher resolution. And of course, if you can see any captions, kapag may captions po dyan sa ibaba, po pwede nyo din pong hanapin yung CC and change the setting, no? I-off po yung ating caption. And again, no, our reminder, our encouragement is that you answer the different items that we have here. Put in the item number and of course the letter of your choice so that your learning becomes more active and so learning becomes more meaningful. Na mas tumatatak po sa ating mga isipan yung lahat ng ating mga kasagutan, no? Ligwak man o hindi, ang importante po ay tayo natututo. And of course, sa actual na licensure exam for teachers, maling-mani, no? Maning-mani na lamang po yung ating mga questions. Okay, but of course, just like every time that we have our live stream, let us all have our opening prayer. So samahan niyo po ako mga kaguro. Dear Lord, I come to you to ask for your guidance and direction in this study session. I ask that the Holy Spirit fill me with strength, creativity, and understanding to get through my studies without difficulty or sin. Help me hold my focus and attention. Help me to retain all that I learned. Please make my mind sharp and keep distractions at bay. If any part of my studying is weak or lacking in some way, let it be revealed so that I may correct it. Thank you for this opportunity to learn. Amen. All right, now once again, this is your refresher for Gen Ed Science team doing mag-ingay. And of course, like, love, share our video. As I'm waiting for all of you to share our video, gusto ko lamang batiin lahat ng mga nagko-comment dito. Nag-stop po ba? Hindi po nag-stop, Ma'am Melody. Okay, from Hong Kong, Ma'am Jonah Famatid. Ingat po kayo dyan. Of course, good evening. Good evening, Ma'am Nora or Ma'am Norey Lapuan. Maraming salamat, Sir Bill Jun. Vils Hernandez Hop for tagging all of your friends. Good evening, Ma'am Noria Lee de Guzman. Good evening, Ma'am Jenlyn Verdida. Sister Anthony Val Acosta, LPT, very, very soon. Good evening po. Ma'am Chris or Sir Chris Ponferrada, good evening, from San Miguel Leyte. Okay, who else? Good evening from San Carlos City, Negros Occidental. Sir Rexy Perino or Ma'am Rexy Perino, hindi ka pa po late, no? Hindi pa po tayo magsa-start. From the University of Cebu, Lapu-Lapu and Mandaue, Sir Junior Velasquez. Good evening po. From Cebu City, Ma'am Joan Englis. Oh, good evening. Ma'am Angeline Cabasag, LPT, very soon. Ma'am Carmela Carlem, LPT, very, very soon. Okay, maraming salamat. And of course, good evening to all of you. And it might also be good morning and good afternoon for the rest of our kaguro na nandyan po sa ibang bahagi ng mundo. And of course, no, we will be starting in a few seconds. Again, paki-like, love, and share na po ng ating video. Ma'am Mardy or Sir Mardy. Hello, Ma'am Mek. It's nice to hear you again. October 2022, Pastor. Thanks for your help and good luck po sa inyong lahat. Maraming salamat for taking the time to revisit your home. Thank you po. Ma'am Christine Visorio, good evening po. Ayon, meron taga Pampanga, meron taga Cebu Province, Sorsogon, okay, all over the Philippines. And of course, meron din tayo dito from SPLA Kuwait, no, si Sir or Ma'am Ray Misser. Okay. All right, Quezon City. Marami yatang taga Cebu. Okay, let's all start with item number one. Again, put in the item number and of course, the letter of your choice. From Hong Kong, Ma'am Jane Abukay. Good evening po. Okay, number one, the Philippines, which is made up of thousands of islands, is called blank. Could this be letter A, Gulf? Letter B, Cape? Letter C, Archipelago? Or letter D, Peninsula? What is our choice? Number one, tumpak kaya? Question number one pa lamang? Or meron kaya maagang maliligwak? Tingnan natin. Ma'am Juna from Lanao del Norte, Kapatagan. Hello po. Good evening. Ma'am Marikis Mandani. Mari Chris Mandani from Dasmariñas, Cavite. Good evening po sa inyo. Okay, I see a lot of letter C's. At mukhang tama ang ating mga kaguro. No? Mukhang tama ang gurong Pinoy ng ating mga kababayan. Ma'am Dwivelin Lonzaga from Thailand. Good evening po. Okay, tumpak na choice of course natin dito. The term that we are looking for, if we are talking about the Philippines being made up of thousands of islands, of course, tumpak na choice natin dito would be letter C, archipelago. Ayan, sabi ni Facebook user, ibibilad ko sa init ng araw ang magkakamali dito. Huwag naman po, sobrang init ngayon, no? Magkaka-heatstroke po tayo. Okay, so letter C, archipelago, ang ating pong tumpak na choice. Now, this question is very common. And this question, I think we have all encountered since grade school. No? Mukhang elementary pa lamang tayo, alam na natin ang tumpak na choice dito. Now, what about the rest of our choices here? No? The first one, Gulf. No? You can pronounce this, some people pronounce this as Gulf. No? Dati Gulf din. Pero you can also pronounce it as Gulf. Okay, so Gulf, it's a body of water partially surrounded by land. No? So this is not a landform. Kumbaga, we are talking about your body of water here for choice A. Choice B mo, a cape. No? A cape is a pointed piece of land. This time, we're talking about your landform. No? So this is a pointed piece of land extending to the sea. Okay, so kumbaga, kaparti siya ng lupa na nag-e-extend hanggang sa dagat. That's your cape. Kaya nga cape, di ba? Para siyang kapa. Pointed piece of land extending to the sea. And of course, letter D, ang letter D mo, peninsula, halos po magkapareha sila ng cape, no? This is land surrounded by water on three sides, but this is larger than a cape. Mas malaki lamang siya kesa sa inyong cave. Okay? So again, tumpak na choice natin, archipelago. Thousands of islands. Okay? So archipelago, letter C. Congratulations sa mga nakakuha ng tumpak na choice. Halos lahat kayo, no? Ay tumpak po ang inyong choice. Okay? So let's take a look at our pictures, no? This is an example of your Gulf. This one right here, no? Davao. Okay, so it is again a body of water which is surrounded or almost surrounded by your land. Okay, so almost surrounded siya. Kumbaga, isang parte lamang yung hindi sakop ng lupa, no? And this here is an example of your cape. Okay, remember your cape, pointed piece of land extending to the sea, no? So example here is the Cape San Agustin in Davao Oriental, no? Good evening po sa mga taga Davao. Wow, no? Good evening po sa inyong lahat. And of course, this right here is an example of your peninsula, Zamboanga Peninsula. As you can see, halos magka-structure po sila ng cape, but of course, this one right here is bigger than your cape because ito kanina yung cape natin, okay? So this is your Cape San Agustino, nasa Davao Oriental. Okay, so this here is an example of our peninsula right here in the Philippines. That's your Zamboanga Peninsula. Okay, so three sides of it are surrounded by water. And of course, no, it is also extending towards the sea. All right, but our correct choice is letter C, archipelago, for item number one. We go to item number two. Good evening din sa mga taga Zambo, no? Sa mga taga Zamboanga. Good evening po. Okay, number two, when the North Pole is tilted towards the sun, it is summer, and when the sun shines all the time, both day and night, what is this phenomenon called? Would this be letter A, twilight sun? Letter B, summer light? Letter C, northern light? Or letter D, midnight sun? What is your choice for number two? Please put in number two and of course the letter of your choice. I see a lot of letter Ds. Naku, mukhang absent si Daniel Padilla. Nasaan si Daniel Padilla? Absent yata si Daniel Padilla today, no? Or tonight. Okay, letter D kaya ang ating tumpak na choice. Letter D, midnight sun. The midnight sun, no? So sabi dito, ano ba yung tawag natin sa phenomenon, natural occurrence, kung saan yung sun ay shining all the time, both day and night, no? So halos pa 24 hours na nakikita natin yung sun, no? Ay, and dyan pala si Daniel Padilla. Hello po, good evening. Okay, tumpak na choice of course here is letter D. Midnight sun is tumpak for number two. Congratulations, okay? So one very familiar place for all of us where we can see the midnight sun is of course Norway, no? So marami tayong nangangarap dito makapunta sa Norway, di ba? Makita yung mga natural occurrence na meron dyan. The phenomenon called your midnight sun, of course, even the northern lights na yung tinatawag nating aurora borealis, okay? So that's your midnight sun. Letter D is tumpak. We go to item number three, okay? Sabi ni Ma'am Erica Pai Villasante, si Sir Daniel tahimik lang, no? Mukhang mending the broken heart pa si Sir Daniel Padilla. Okay, number three, a forest suffered from wildfires and destroys the existing vegetation. However, the soil remained viable. 5 years later, trees and bushes are seen flourishing in the forest once again. This phenomenon is called, would this be letter A, primary ecological succession? Letter B, tertiary ecological succession? Letter C, quaternary ecological succession? Or letter D, secondary ecological succession? Okay, so sabi dito, no, there had been wildfires. Okay, existing vegetation were destroyed or was destroyed. And of course, 5 years later, new trees, okay, and bushes are seen flourishing in the forest once again. What is this? Letter A, primary. Letter B, tertiary. Letter C, quaternary. Or letter D, secondary ecological succession. What is our choice? Okay, letter D. Letter D, nakikita kong mas karamihang choice ng taong bayan. And of course, no, tumpak na choice po natin dito would be letter D, secondary ecological succession. Dalawa lang naman, no, yung klase ng ating ecological succession. So here is the difference, no? So The first one is primary, unang-una. And of course, you have your secondary ecological succession. Now, what is the difference? When you say primary succession or primary ecological succession, you started with barren landscape. So wala talagang laman ang lupa, no? Wala talagang vegetation. Kumbaga, uhaw ang tigang na lupa, di ba? Uhaw ang tigang na lupa na walang grass, walang lichens, walang moss, walang algae, walang whatever dyan sa lupa mo. No? Maaring wala nga ding uod, di ba? Kasi barren siya, wala talaga, no? And eventually, some species would start to thrive, no? Magkakaroon siya ng bagong-bagong pinakaunang group of species niya. You call this pioneer, no? Naunang klase ng species. Katulad ng mga pioneer, no? Katulad ng when you say pioneer batch ka ng K-12, unang-una kayong gumraduate as products of K-12, no? Then you have your intermediate community, and finally, you'd have your climax community, no? Climax species, kapag sinabi mong climax, ruro, halos wala nang pagbabago, halos wala nang nagbabago, halos the same na yung klase ng species meron sa isang ecosystem, okay? So that's your climax community. And then, sometimes, your perturbation might happen. No? So when you say perturbation here, any disturbance, maaaring meron kang illegal logging, nautod, naubos, lahat po ng mga puno, or po pwedeng wildfires, grass fires, na very common right now, no? Or po pwedeng nagkaroon ng landslides or avalanche, for example, if we have snow, okay? So perturbation, again, this is any disturbance in the community or in the ecosystem. But still, the land is viable. The land is still rich in nutrients. And so eventually, kagaya po ng question natin kanina, after 5 years, meron ulit mga tumubong mga plants, no? Mga tumubong mga species, okay? So you'd call this your secondary succession. Basta after your perturbation, after any disturbance like wildfires, grass fires, your landslides, no? Earthquakes, maaari, no? So your secondary succession would happen. Your primary succession would start when you have a barren landscape. Wala talagang laman yung lupa, okay? And so tumpak na choice natin there was letter D, secondary succession for this item. We go to item number 4. An atom of silicon has a mass number of 28 and an atomic number of 40. And how many protons are in this atom? Would it be letter A, 28, letter B, 12, letter C, 7, or letter D, 14? And what is our choice? Okay. Sabi dito ni Ma'am Maggie, bakit po kaya wala ako na-receive na email sa quiz kanina? Last Monday naman po, di ko na siya ma-open kasi done na po sa discussion. Okay, sa mga bago nating members, so make sure that you have watched our orientation video. Meron pong instructions doon kung paano natin ginagawa yung ating review, no? At every time na meron po nakapost ng quizzes, wala na po mag-notify sa inyo. Just make sure, no? Always check your quizzes classroom, na yung quizzes class nyo po. Pabalik-balik kayo sa quizzes, especially if you know na bukas eh merong discussion, no? A day before our discussion, nakapost na po yung ating quizzes, dyan po sa ating quizzes class. No? Wala na po sa email, basta nakapasok na po kayo sa quizzes class, just check lang your quizzes class every time that you have a discussion the following day. Okay? So, kunwari, sa Friday, meron po tayong discussion with Coach June, no? So, check nyo yung inyo pong quizzes by Thursday kung meron na pong naka-assign na mga items ni Coach June. Okay? All right, I see letter D. Need pa po ng code? No need po for the code. Okay? Wala po, o hindi na po kailangan ng code. Ma'am Windy or Sir Windy. Hi, Coach Mac. Good eve. Team Pavlov here waiting for the lab result. Of course, siguradong papasa na. Okay, letter D kaya ang ating tumpak na choice for number 4, 14. Okay, so dito sabi, no, meron tayong atom ng silicon and it has a mass number of 28. That's the mass number. Atomic number is 14. Now, ang question is how many protons are there in this atom? Tumpak na choice natin dito is letter D, 14. Tama yung number 14, no? Or ang 14 na choice. Bakit? No, remember your ape man. In a neutral atom, your atomic number would be equal to your number of protons, also equal to the number of electrons. protons. So kahit ano po yung atomic number mo, if the question is about the number of protons, which is usually the question sa ating licensure exam, equal lang po yung inyong magiging choice. No? Kapag ito ay 17, 17 din yung inyong proton number. Kapag ito ay 100, 100 din yung meron kang protons in this atom. Okay, so 8 atomic number should always be equal to your number of protons and will always be equal to your number of electrons in a neutral atom. Now, what about your man? No? Ano naman yung man dito? Mass number minus your atomic number is equal to your number of neutrons. Kumbaga, if you have a mass number of 28 and you subtract the atomic number of 14, the number of neutrons in your silicon atom would be 14. No? So 14 din po yung kanyang silicon atom. Okay? And so tumpak na choice would be letter D. Letter D. Now let's take a look at some examples. Let's try. Let's try. Okay. What about this? You try. No? Calculate 8 man. Okay? 8 man. Una, ilang protons meron tayo? Please try to round this up. No? So round this into 7. Ilan yung protons mo? Ilan yung protons mo dito? Ilan po yung protons mo? For this example, protons po muna. Ilan po yung ating protons? Remember, 8 man. Atomic number is equal to your protons and electrons. Now, no, some of you might get confused dahil meron tayong dalawang numbers dito. Now, you have 3 and 7. Alin kaya yung atomic number? No? If you see these two numbers, the higher number would always be your mass number. Mass po ito. Okay, this is your mass number. Yung pinakamalaking number would always be the mass number. And so this right here is your atomic number. Okay, so number of protons mo would be, ilan po yung protons natin? 3, tama, no? So 3 po yung protons natin. What about if the question is number of neutrons? Number of neutrons natin, ilan? Remember, man, mass number minus atomic number would be equal to your number of neutrons. Ayun, Facebook user says 4. Okay, 4. Sabi ni Ma'am Janaika Ismael. Okay, 4. Neutron po, yung ating hinahanap ha. Ma'am Clydine says 4. No? So paano nakuha yung 4? That's 7 minus 3. Man, remember, M, mass, minus atomic number would be equal to your number of neutrons. Okay, so 7 minus 3, that would be 4 neutrons. Your electrons should also be 3. Okay, so 3 din yung electrons mo, that would still be equal to your atomic number. Okay, what about this one right here? Aha. This one, alam nyo na to. Diba? Okay, so this is your atomic number. This is your atomic mass. Okay, so just that should just be equal to 28. What is the number of protons and the number of neutrons? Protons at neutrons na lang po. Pakilagay sa ating comment box. Both the number of neutrons and or number of protons, I mean, and neutrons. Number of protons and neutrons. Okay, proton, 14. And neutron is also 14. Okay, so proton 14, neutron 14. Tama, no? So proton mo is 14 because you have your atomic number is 14 here. And of course, ang neutron mo naman po is mass number, that's 28, minus atomic number 14, that would still give you 14. Okay, so nagkataon lamang na parehas, no? But make sure that you know the formula. Okay, so that's correct, no? Proton number is 14 and number of neutrons would also be 14. All right. We go to the next item. When a bee gathers nectar from a certain type of flower to make honey, and in the process pollinates the flower, what kind of relationship exists between the bee and the flower? Would this be letter A, parasitic, letter B, mutualistic, letter C, commensalistic, or letter D, serendipitous? What is our choice? You have a bee gathering nectar, and in the process, the bee pollinates the flower. So what kind of relationship do they have? I see letter B is for item number 5. Tama kaya ang letter B for this item? Naku, naku, naku. Okay, tama kaya? Or tamang ligwa kaya ang mangyari? Okay. All right, letter B, mutualistic talaga. Gusto niyo talaga letter B, ha? pinangangatawanan ang letter B ng taong bahay ng ating mga kaguro, no? So, sabi dito, letter B, mutualistic kaya ang ating relationship, no? So, meron kang meron kang bubuyog, no? Bubuyog na nag-gather ng nectar, no? So, that means yung bubuyog ay nakakakuha ng food mula dun sa flower. And of course, in the process, dahil nga agent of pollination yung bee, no? In the process, the flower gets pollinated, no? So, nagkakaroon ng pollination na process dahil sa pagkakaroon mo ng bubuyog, no? Na merong mga pollen grains sa kanyang paa. And so, what kind of relationship do we have here? Tumpak na choice, of course, here is letter B, mutualistic. Pareha silang may benefit, di ba? So, pareha silang happy. And so, that would be letter B for item number 5. No? So again, these are some examples of your symbiotic relationships. And when you say symbiosis, this is any relationship where two or more species live closely together. Okay, you have two species living closely together, and so they form certain types of relationships. The first one that we have is mutualism. And so here, no, an example of your mutualism is the one that we have sa ating pong question. Both of them get benefit, and so this is plus plus. Everybody is happy, di ba? So both of them are happy. Commensalism, the second type here, no? Ang choice natin, one is happy, one gets some benefits, while the other one is unaffected. Walang pakialam, no? Dead ma yung other organism, okay? So kunwari ito, no? So this little person here, the little green organism that we have here, gets some benefit kasi meron siyang shade, di ba? Meron siyang shelter. Pero yung malaking organism naman natin dito, dead ma lang, wala siyang benefit, wala din naman siyang harm, no? Wala ding harm na nakukuha dahil sa kanilang commensalistic relationship. Now, this one is parasitism. Meron kang isang happy, ayan, kasi kumakain, no? The organism that gives harm to the other organism, no? that one would get some benefit. Well, the other one here, your red organism is harmed kasi nga siya ay kinakagat, no? So, in the real world, we call this harmed organism, itong merong harm, nagkaka-harm, that is called the host, no? Host is harmed. That's your hint, host harmed. And of course, your parasite benefits, okay? So, your parasite is the one that is happy, no? So their type of relationship is parasitism. One is happy, the other one is sad, no? So kayo, ano po yung relationship ninyo ng jowa mo? Daniel Padilla, pakisagot, okay? And so letter B po ang ating tumpak na choice for this item. All right, we go to number 6. Okay, ito. Kayang-kaya niyong sagutin po ito, mga kaguro, kasi kaka-discuss lamang natin. What is commensalism? Is this letter A? An association where both species benefit. Both benefit. Letter B, an association where the larger species benefits and the smaller species is harmed. Letter C, an association where one species is killed or inhibited and the other organism is not significantly affected. Or letter D, an association where one species benefits and the other species is not significantly affected. What is our choice? Ayun. Mukhang mga nakatunog, no? Kung mali man, kung ligwak man sa quizzes, sigurado ngayon, ay tumpak ang inyong choice. Because of course, no, kaka-discuss pa lang natin. Huwag naman masyadong mabilis magka-amnesia. Okay. What is our choice? I see letter D is for this item. And of course, letter D po ang ating tumpak na choice. When you say commensalism, one benefits, the other one is dead ma. Okay? Sana hindi ganito ang inyong relasyon. Okay? So sana po, doon tayo sa relationship na mutual, na mutualism. Okay? So letter D for this item. We go to item number 7. Perfumes contain organic compounds called very common item in the lab, no? Gen Ed. Letter A, acids. Letter B, alcohol. Letter C, ethers. Or letter D, esters. What is your choice? Okay, so again, if you'd want to enjoy our full-length video, dire-diretso panunood, wala pong pagpuputol, wala pong napuputulan, you can answer our quizzes, you can download all our files, become a member of Gurung Pinoy, just send a message to our Facebook page. Okay, I see letter D for number 7. Tumpa kaya ang letter D? medyo mga meron pa mga nalilito at meron pa pong naliligwak. Okay? So okay lang po 'yan. Ma'am Josel Dumalag, hello po. Good evening. Okay, letter D. Karamihang choice niyo letter D for number 7. Perfumes contain organic compounds called tumpak na choice natin. Of course, here is letter D. Esters. Now remember our mnemonic, my perfume si Esther. Okay? My perfume si Esther. Okay, so that's your hint, no? Basta perfume, ang pinag-uusapan si Esther po, ang ating hahanapin. Okay, so letter D, my perfume si Esther. Alright, hindi ko na i-discuss yung iba dyan kasi hindi naman siya, hindi naman sila masyadong nakikita sa ating gen ed, no? So, iwanan na natin yan, paubayan na natin sa ating mga science major. Okay, we go to number 8. What can an herbivore be categorized as? Would it be letter A, a detritivore? Letter B, an autotroph? Letter C, a producer? Or letter D, a primary consumer? What is our choice? Ligwak, yehey! Sabi ni Facebook user. Nako, acids lang daw, tsaka alcohol yung kilala ng isa nating kaguro. Mukhang... Ah, okay. So, sabi ni Ma'am Juna, no? Acids at alcohol lang. Okay, ang kanyang kilala. Okay, so sa ngayon, kilala na ni Ma'am Juna si Esther. Alright, what is your choice? Nako, samuksare. Halo-halo po. Ang choice ng taong bayan. But I see a lot of letter Ds. Tama kaya ang letter D for this item? What can an herbivore be categorized as? Would this be letter A, detritivore? Letter B, autotroph? Letter C, producer? Or letter D, a primary consumer? Tumpak na choice natin here is letter D, a primary consumer. Ang ating pong tumpak na choice, no? You remember your autotroph and producer, parehas lang po yan, no? So when you say producer, it is an organism that can make its own food. So this is your autotroph or your plants, diba? These are your plants. And of course, detritivore mo naman, these are organisms that feed off from decaying materials, no? From decaying materials. Ito yung mga nagbabalik ng nutrients sa ating soil, okay? So that's your detritivore, no? And so tumpak na choice natin here is primary consumer. Para po mas malinaw, let's take a look at our illustration here. Now, this right here is an example of your food chain, no? So this is your food chain. Makinig, makinig ng maigi. Ang dami pong questions regarding your food chain and your food web sa ating let, no? Unang-unang question doon, very familiar kayo sa question na ito. What is the only source of energy on Earth? Your answer would be the sun, okay? So, kagaya dito sa ating food chain, you need the sun and water, of course, no? Along with your carbon dioxide, so that your plants or your producer, or another term would be your autotrophs, can make their own food, di ba? Your process, which we all know as photosynthesis. Now, meron po tayong mga tinatawag na herbivore. Ito kanina yung ating question, di ba? Your herbivore are organisms that can only eat plants, di ba? So these are plant-eating animals or plant-eating organisms. And so, yan po kanina yung ating choice. Kasi yung tinatanong primary consumer, no? Yung unang kumonsumo, yung unang kumain ng producer, that would be your plant-eating organism, and so that's your herbivore, okay? Now, you also have your omnivore, no? Katulad ng inyong mouse dito, no? Mouse, that's your secondary consumer. Secondary consumer po siya kasi kinain niya ang primary consumer mo, di ba? So, kinain po niya yung primary consumer na grasshopper, and so now, it is called your secondary consumer. Now, your mouse is also considered an omnivore because it can eat meat, or other animals, and also plants, no? Pwede din kasi siyang ngumitngit, no? Or mumatngat ng plants, no? So, omnivore, they can both eat your plants and meat. Katulad natin humans, di ba? Plant eaters and meat eaters tayo. Now, you have your tertiary consumer since this snake right here has eaten your secondary consumer. You call this your tertiary consumer. It is considered a carnivore kasi wala po yung plant sa kanyang diet, okay? Hindi siya kumakain ng plants. And so, it is meat eater. It is a meat eater and we call it a carnivore. Now, the term is carnivore. And you also have another tertiary consumer here, no? Kung pwede siyang maging tertiary, ang brain mo dito, ang eagle mo, for example, no? Pupwede siyang maging tertiary or pupwede din naman siyang maging quaternary consumer. Pupwede niyang kainin itong tertiary consumer mo or pupwede din niyang kainin itong secondary consumer. Kaya siya pupwede din maging tertiary consumer. And of course, this is also your carnivore. Now, this right here, your mushroom, is an example of your decomposer, no? Decomposer, your detritivores. Yung mga nagbabalik ng nutrients sa ating pong soil, okay? So, klarong claro, your herbivore is considered a primary consumer. Okay? Sana po ay klaro na. We go to item number 9. Ayan, Sir Dave Soriano. Thank you po, ma'am. Nang dahil sa inyo, LPT na po ako. Congratulations. And of course, maraming salamat for visiting us. All right, number 9. What constitutes a food web? Ayan, konektado sa ating question number 8. Now, what constitutes a food web? Would it be letter A, a sequence of organisms that feed on each other? Letter B, a complex food chain that consists of omnivores who feed on both herbivores and other omnivores? Letter C, a combination of food chains that are interconnected to create a network of feeding relationships? Or is it letter D, a sequence of omnivores who feed on each other? Sequence of organisms, sequence of omnivores, complex food chain. Okay, what is your choice? I see letter C, yes, no? So again, I am encouraging all of you to join Team Dewey, Our Left Babies, for September this year. Of course, dire-diretso po yung ating discussion, ang ating pagre-review, no, para po maipasa yung licensure exam for teachers. For September, we also have our majorship coaches na andyan din, nakaantabay na para po sa pagsisimula ng ating majorships. Okay, so very easy to become a member. Send a message to this Facebook page. Aside from the left, we also have the Civil Service Review. And of course, we also have the NAPLCOM Review. Okay, ayan, sabi ni Ma'am Sophia, letter C, kasi siya lang ang mahaba at maganda ang construction. Nako, medyo bias si Ma'am Sophia sa mahaba. Okay, ang mahaba kaya ay tama for item number 9? Alright, tumpak na choice natin here would be letter C. Buti na lang, tumpak ang mahaba for number 9. Okay, so ano yung mga hints mo dito sa ating letter C? No, ayan po, combination, interconnected. Usually sa question natin, intertwined. So intertwined networks. Okay, so that would be some of your, or those would be some of your hints here. So letter C po ang ating tumpak na choice. All right, we go to item number 10. No? But bago yan, this right here are some illustrations of your food chain and your food web. No? So nakikita ninyo, klarong-klaro, mas magulo ang food web. Mas magulo pa kaysa sa relasyon nyo. Nako po, no? Intertwined, interconnected, complex network. Okay, so okay, yung food chain mo naman, napakahayahay lang, di ba? One chain lamang ang inyong sinusundan. Alright, we go to number 10. Which of these structures helps plant cells maintain their regular shape? Would this be letter A, chloroplast? Letter B, cell wall? Letter C, cell membrane? Or letter D, nucleus? What is our choice? Ma'am Erica Murillo says, pero chinek ko po yung Gmail ko, wala naman pong mail. Paano po kaya yon? Mag-send po ng message mamaya, no? Basta any questions, any concerns, kapag may problema, mag-send lamang po ng message dito sa ating page. No? Meron po tayong mga admin dyan, no? Please be patient since out of office hours na po. So bukas po babalik yung ating admin. Okay, number 10, letter B. Tama kaya ang letter B, cell wall? Merong ilang iba ang sagot? Sino kaya ang tumpak at alin kaya ang ligwak? Yes, meron pong quiz kanina sa science, Ma'am Janina. Okay, number 10. Which of these structures helps plant cells maintain their rectangular shape? Tumpak na choice natin here would be letter B, cell wall, because of the term plant cells and rectangular shape, no? The rest of your choices, no? Although meron ko din namang chloroplast na makikita lamang sa inyong plants, hindi yan po yung purpose ng inyong chloroplast. Your chloroplast is for photosynthesis, di ba? Dyan po yung inyong chlorophyll, ang pigment, no, na nag-gather ng sunlight para gamitin siya for your photosynthesis. Cell membrane, hindi po na cell membrane. All types of animals would have cell membrane, your plasma membrane or cell membrane. The nucleus, this is the brain of the cell that controls all the processes inside the cell. Now, we will take a look at the different organelles that we have there later. No? But bago yan, these are some differences between your plant cell and your animal cell. So, ayan, no? Nakikita nyo, yung plant cell mo po is rectangular, while your animal cell circular. Okay, so circular siya usually. And what are some of the structures that you can find sa inyong pong plant cell na wala sa animal cell and vice versa? Okay, so sa plant cell po, nakakakita ka ng cell wall. Yan po yung ating sagot dito, no? So the cell wall, it is made up of cellulose, no? So usually we say cellulose cell wall. Siya po na yung nag-maintain, no, ng rigidity, ng rectangular shape ng ating pong plant cells. Then of course, you have the chloroplast. These ones are your chloroplast, yung green po na structure inside your plant cell, no? So this right here is the site of photosynthesis. Diyan po nangyayari yung photosynthesis kasi po nandiyan yung chlorophyll, no? Chlorophyll. Then of course you also have the central vacuole. Ito po yung central vacuole mo. Mas malaki po yung vacuole sa plant cell kaysa sa animal cell kasi yung purpose po ng inyong central vacuole sa plant cell is storage ng tubig, okay? Which we know is very important para sa ating mga plants. Kaya nga maraming tuyot na plants ngayon kasi wala tayong tubig kasi nga napaka-taas po ng ating heat index, okay? Now, what are some of the structures that you might just find in your animal cell but not in your plant cell? No, unang-una, centriole. Ito po yung centrioles mo, no? So, pare sila ng parang macaroni shape na mga organelles and they help in cell division, no? So, wala po sila sa plant cell mo. And you also have your flagella. Yung flagella, this is a whip-like structure that aids in locomotion. Wala lang flagella itong ating drawing. So parang ganun siya, no? Kunwari, nakikita mo sa sperm cell, kaya nakakagalaw yung sperm cell, no? In other types of your protist, no? Sa iba't ibang klase ng ating pang-organisms. Pero wala siya sa plant cell, okay? So those are some differences between our plant cell and animal cell, no? But bago tayo pumunta sa number 11, no? So ito po yung ating simplified na type of cell with the different structures, no? Let's take a look at the different parts. Yung mga i-discuss ko lamang po ay yung mga nalabas sa inyong licensure exam, no? Gen Ed Science, okay? So here is the nucleus. O yan, di ba? Nagmamarunong. Itong inyong nucleus, meron po siyang headphones, di ba? Kasi siya po yung tagamando, di ba? Sabi ko kanina, that is the brain of the cell. Siya po yung nakakontrol ng lahat ng processes inside the cell. Oy, kailangan na ito, no? Ipasok ito, ilabas ito, no? Kailangan pa natin mag-produce sa mas maraming protina. For example, no? Oy, may bacteria or meron mikrobyo. Kailangan natin gawin to, no? So that's your nucleus, alright? So that's the brain of the cell. Control all the processes inside the cell. Maliban po dyan, very important din siya because this is where you find your DNA, no? Your genetic information, genetic material inside the cell. Hindi ko na po i-discuss itong ating endoplasmic reticulum, paubaya sa GenSci major. Yung mga lumalabas po sa left, no? Itong ating Golgi body, hindi na po. Cytoplasm, hindi na rin po, no? But ito yung mga lumalabas sa left gen natin. Mitochondria, ito pong kidney-shaped structure inside your cell, no? This is the site for or the site of cellular respiration. Paggawa po ng energy sa cell, no? Paggawa ng ATP, which is the energy currency of the cell. So para siyang Meralco, para po siyang Eleco, Peco, Amor, no? Amor, more power pala, more power, Gimelco, kung ano pa yung electric company niyo sa inyong pong lugar, okay? So that's your mitochondria, the powerhouse of the cell, makes ATP, which is the energy of the cell, in a process called cellular respiration, okay? Yung ribosomes, hindi natin natatanong to na cell membrane, hindi naman masyado, no? Except for the cell wall kanina sa ating plants. Lysosomes, these are called the suicide bags of the cell, okay? Suicide bags of the cell po ito. Siya yung nagda-digest ng mga parte ng cell na hindi na kailangan. Okay, so sounds like Lysol, tagapatay ng germs, no? Tagapatay ng mga kung anik-anik, no? So lysosome, it has some digestive enzymes, okay? So that's your lysosome. And of course, the vacuole, napag-usapan po natin to kanina sa ating plant cell. In the case of your animal cell, po, pwede pong meron siyang vacuole, pero mas maliit kaysa sa central vacuole na meron ka sa inyong plant cell, no? So essentially, sa ating pong animal cell, since this is an animal cell, the function of your vacuole is storage of waste, storage of food, no? Mga crystals mo, some water, no? Makikita po yan sa inyong vacuole, alright? Sana po klaro, we go to the next item. Next item po. Number 11, humans often manipulate plants in order to create results that are better fit for their needs. Or for their needs. What process is often used to create new hybrids of grapes for making wine? Would this be letter A, bulbs, letter B, grafting, letter C, rhizomes, or letter D, stolons? What is our choice? Again, if you'd want to become or to watch the full video, download our files, join our quizzes, send a message to our Facebook page. Okay, be